All right, we're going to try this one more time. So I got some advice from Trizza. Shout out to Trizza. Trizza Flock of Flame. Trying to get this live to work. This is insanity. Just overnight, Mac just stopped working on live stream. Just overnight for I don't know what reason. So you're going to see me banging my head up against the wall till we figure it out. But if you do see frame drops and the little circle button and all this, then we'll have to figure it out even more. So we left off with these guitar melodies. You want to write in triplets, so go to your Snap to Grid, go to 1/3 beat. Now we're at 108 BPM, so you want to make sure that you're at a slower BPM when you write the melodies. If you want to make it a higher BPM, you can hit Option, highlight everything, hit Control to highlight everything, hit Option, and left click and drag out the melody. And this will make it go to a higher BPM. So let's say you wanted to do it at 160. Writing in triplets at a higher BPM, you won't, the lines don't really match up. So maybe 1/3. I don't think there's anything bigger than that. Cloud D is back. Mac is the best. I'm just curious why streaming is so difficult. But just let me know, alarm me or warn me if it starts getting crappy on your end. And then I just got to consult with somebody to figure it out. Merrill Beats, hello. All right, so it says we have 9 folks in here. Cool. All right, just let me know again if it starts screwing up and all this. Now that we have the melody, this sound is from Amp Guitar, Ample Guitar M, or Ample Guitar Martin, it's called. And what I'm going to do is throw a capo on or a capo. And I forget what button it is. Yeah, so there's... This basically is going to transform the key. It just sounds cooler, and the way they play is different. So keep in mind, the MIDI doesn't change. So you're going to be, don't look at these notes like these are the right notes. Technically, everything was pulled up a note. It just has a different feel. So when you use the capo or capo, this gives you a different vibe. Now, if you wanted to extend this, you could make the first hit a chord. So you want to look at fifths, like C, G. And how do you say that? Kasanathi Madida. I don't know how to pronounce that, but shout out to you. Is the stream good? What do you rate it out of 10? Let me know. All right, so without being frustrated about the stream, just gonna keep focusing on the music here. What you could do is like a little triplet, like a little 3-note hit or 2-note hit. And I do what? So now that we have the guitar melody, why is this thing scratchy? I'm literally about to throw this computer out the window. Oh, we're using Macs, no wonder. Goodness, why was that on Mac speaker? Oh, I forgot to switch it back, that's why. Man, I'm telling you, drive you insane. Let me make sure I have my sound on the right thing. Output good, input UA, okay. Okay, so now let's just add some drums up in here. Now you could make it like brim brim brim, 1, 2, 3, 1. So Loner Square is here. So you could do something like this, hit Option, just left click. Just kind of strum into the next note. It's got a hammer on technically. You could do this technique. Now, is that realistic? Probably not, but it sounds cool. Now, at the end, I want it to change. Now I'm going to use the three rule. I showed this in a different video. I forget which video, but we're just going to make sure the notes are three notes away from each other. So this one is one, two, three. That's three notes away. Next note, one, two, three, needs to be up two. So hit shift up, one, two. Then the next note, one, two, three. In this case, this note is really low down, so let's pull it up an octave, hit control up. So we know that it's fine. I'm gonna change that last note. Yes, feedback's at nine. In could be better. Sounds kind of whatever. Let's pull this up. So it's one, two, three, three. There we go. See how it just, it finishes and then it wraps back into itself. So that rule of three really helps. It's a technique they even use in art. It's called the rule of three. So you want to start using that in your melody. Add a little detail to this guitar to make it sound less like plug-in-esque. Let's add a fruity delay three. And let's go to wet level, turn dry level down, turn your time modulation up. Turn feedback down, turn delay time down. You could add dry back if you want like a chorusy effect. This gives it like a Travis Scott vibe. So now I want to add another fruity delay three. And then turn feedback level down, delay time down, time modulation up. Turn wet level all the way up, dry level down. Where did my mouse go? My mouse disappeared. What the heck? My mouse literally just disappeared. What the frick? Yo. What? What do you even do if your mouse disappears? I have no... What is going on with the universe right now? Stuff just does not want to work. This is insanity. My mouse just disappeared. I have no idea where it is. Does anybody know how to get it back? There we go. The freak is going on, man. This might be too much modulation, so we're just going to pull it back. I'm going to add a little offset so the chorus isn't like mono sounding. Jamayel, what's up? Kid Astro, yeah, we're doing the feedback. Yo, Busy, are you doing the song feedback? Yeah, we're going to do it at 9. Shout out to Stropkus. I was just testing out the live because we've been having issues with the live. So let me know if your screen does anything weird. Let's convert this into audio. Right click, consolidate track from start. Shout out to Trizzy for helping me out, because if he didn't drop that tip or hint, I would have been frustrated. So as a thank you, we're going to use, I bought his kits because firstly, I like them and they were on my other computer, but I forgot to transfer the kits over. So they're from theproducerkit.com. I'll leave a link below once the video is done. So him and I think, I don't know if Diego worked on the second one, but him and Diego have worked on Ultimate 1 or put it together. And I'm not sure about Ultimate 2, but I know that they work together a lot. And, you know, they're both getting records. Diego, I think, is on the Smoke Perp project that just came out. So we're going to stretch the guitar, put it on stretch mode. I haven't talked to Diego in a while. I haven't been out to LA in a while. Sounds a little too stretched, so you always want to check stretch, though. You never know. And let's hit reverse. Nah, it sounds kind of weird. Okay, so let's keep it normal. Do you know how to make something sound wobbly? Yeah, we just did it. Open up Fruity Delay 3. Turn your wet level all the way up. Turn your dry level all the way down. Turn your feedback level all the way down. Turn your delay time all the way down. And basically, what you're doing is making every other knob in effect. So now, if you turn up time modulation, this will create a wobble. Oh, you know what? I don't think this is running through. So that's the wobble effect. thanks, Stropkis, for the update. That kind of adds a cool touch to it. Sometimes wobble can get a little annoying if it's overly done. So you want to try out as many guitar libraries as you like. That one has its pros and cons. I forgot to turn off the reverb. Let's grab an 808 from the Ultimate Kit. Okay, we got 808 flavor. I'm going to trim this out. Now, some I said we're going to do No Kicks 2020. Let's see if we can get away with No Kicks with this type of 808 because it's more punchy. Has a punch to it. Might do the AJ thing where we just slam the 808s. Shout out to AJ on our song feedback stream. How do you read that name? Agni... Wait. OG 90s. I was reading that so wrong. What's up, Swift is here. OG 90s. I'm doing pretty good. Busy. Do you put a saturation plugin on your VST guitars? No, not on an acoustic guitar. Unless you really needed like an edge to it. It would just sound unnatural to have an edge on an acoustic guitar. That's like asking, do you plug in your acoustic guitar into a distortion pedal? And I haven't seen that done very much. Maybe an electric guitar, but not an acoustic. The melody could be better. But you're right, it is on the Travis Scott with that chorus. I could slow the beat down. I think it's just too fast. And it's a little bright, but we're not going to get into the little minutia. Let's just get the 808 rocking. Oh, I like the little doubles thing I did by accident. What up? Neaton, you guys have some hard usernames tonight. Shout out to you. Okay, let's find a snare or a clap. Let's go with the snare. Sounds more aggressive. So we treat the 808 a little bit differently when it's just by itself. A lot going on. So firstly, the guitar is doing too much. I might redo it without the reverb because the reverb kind of gives it a tail that I don't necessarily want, and it makes it sound too plug-in like. So let's go to the effects. Let's turn off all these effects because we don't want it, and I forget which one is which. Here we go. So let's go back to the original melody. Go to your mute tool, the little thing with the little X through it. Just mute it. Now, it might be that the key is very high, so let's go back to the plugin. I know I'm moving pretty fast here, but this is only applies to this plugin. What I'm going to do is pull it back down, the capo. Sometimes you want that darker tone. Now, you got to be careful here not to trigger key switch, which is why FL Studio doesn't handle libraries with key switches very well. Sounds more like Travis Scott to me. No West, what up? Black Pfeiffer? Oh, Black Lifer. Can't read, Megan. Windy City is here, what's up? So it's a lot of movement, so let's pull back some of the movement. Now this sounds more like, it's a little fast, but it sounds more realistic. Using that half step for trap. Then it needs to be. Now I'm getting rid of the three roll here. So I just changed the vibe at the end by moving that three roll. But the three rule does usually work. What's up, Cosas de Rafael? Mr. Malone. OG90 says, I run into this problem and it gets on my nerves like crazy. That it's that when I record on vocal in FL, it sounds offbeat or it's like shifted some late. Yeah. What happens is when you turn on other plugins that aren't made specifically for recording, like this auto-tune, if I talk, notice, well, I don't know if you saw that, but if you hover over the plugin, it will tell you in the top left how much latency that plugin has. So I'm talking, but the plugin makes me sound like I'm a little bit delayed. So the best thing you could do is just go into your audio settings and just lower your buffer length to 123 samples. That's probably as low as you want to go, 123. I mean, 128. Well, hopefully you can still hear me. But 128 is going to give you the best recording speed for most computers. But still, even the new auto-tune adds like a little subtle delay. So what's happening is the plugin is making you sound like you're behind the beat. And what you have to do is compensate. It is annoying as crap. And the workaround, I guess, would just be, I'm trying to think if there is a workaround. There might not be a workaround. It might just have to shift. I know that sucks. The alternative is just turn it off while you're recording and then add it back. But that doesn't help much because you want to hear what you sound like. But I haven't found a what's called a live mode in here, which means you could just record through it. I don't think they have live mode on this one. At least I haven't found it. They might have it somewhere, but I haven't found it. So just keep that in mind. It's auto-tune or some other plugin that you're loading up is causing a delay. That's what the issue is. And again, the velocity is important for a guitar. I just don't want to sit here and do like 10 minutes of, so it's 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So just kind of sing it out loud. 1, 2. So it's. So the volume is not going to be the same all the way through. So every first one, we're going to. Now this note doesn't need to be loud. Just spending this time with the velocity will help, depending on which guitar library you have. This doesn't work every single time for every single library because they're all made different. But notice how it has a little more movement instead of just like ding, 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 and just like shouting at your brain. The Zeus Beats, my bad, I added my head turn. Max, the Siberian Husky. What's up? Funny name. The Siberian Husky. Mark Gray, to help with latency, bounce your beat down to a two-track. Yeah, that could help. But I don't think his issue is necessarily that his computer can't do it. It's just the plugin. He's hearing himself ahead of the beat because the plugin makes him think that he's delayed. I mean, he's hearing him. Yeah, so he's recording ahead of the beat, excuse me, or behind the beat, depending on how the plugin operates. I think what it does is it processes through the plugin, which makes your vocal, even if you're on time, it's going through the plugin, so it delays it. So no matter what your system settings are, it's just going to delay it because of the plugin. The guitar VST is called Ample Guitar M from Ample Sound. But the sounds I'm using, the drums that make it trap, are from theproducerkit.com. It's called the Ultimate Kit. Let me work on these drums. I might need a kick for this track. A trick for your 808 is go to your wrench tool, use time shift, pull that up. Again, the guitar is kind of taking over the show, so you need to tame the volume. A quick way to do that is just add a compressor. Let me see. Let me actually increase my buffer length so that I can add mixing plugins without it getting crazy. So 512 is another sample rate that usually works really well for mixing, at least starting to mix. But if you need more space, you can go to 1028 samples. What did you say? And I'm the guy with the Falcon logo, Busy. Thanks for the shout out. The Falcon logo. Oh, the Falcon logo. Yeah, I remember. Specifically the Falcon logo. The Hawks, the Atlanta Hawks. You got an alias. to add the compressor. Whoops, completely forgot what I was doing there. So let's add, I'm trying to think of a quick compressor for a guitar. I have to use UAD stuff because I don't have my other stuff. But you would just use any compressor that you like. It does not have to be name brand, but I like using specific ones. Let's go to a, let's do the 1176, even though I don't use this on guitar. But I need some, just a basic compressor. Let me see if I can find the distressor from the list. I need to prepare better for my streams. Oh man, there we go. Distressor, let's use AU because I think that's the only one it reads in FL. And did it pop up? No. Let's add both. FL and Mac are a little, there's a couple kinks in here still. Like adding plugins, they don't fully add to your list. Unless I'm like, can't read. But it should be over here, the distressor. I don't see it in the list. So let's keep doing it till it works. All right. Oh, okay, it just popped up out of nowhere. I guess if you click it, it pulls up. I didn't know that. I thought you had to add it to your list first. Well, now I know. All right, so who joined the chat? I turned my head. Zeus is up in here. Kayler 45, what's the scale that it is recommended when you are making a guitar trap? I didn't really start with the scale, but Phrygian mode is one scale you can use. Also, I'm trying to think of another one. People like the Arabic scale for trap. And just any minor, like G minor, C minor, D minor. People love minor keys, but that's kind of basic. But if you're trying to go to a different level, try the Phrygian mode or the Phrygian scale, or try the Arabic scale. It's going to give you a unique sound. Okay, so with the distressor, we're just going to run it through. Tame this guitar a little bit. Now keep in mind, when you have all your sounds super loud and you're trying to compress them, chances are you need to pull them down first and then compress them. Live ones, live events. I'm gonna stay away from people for a long, as long as I can. Cause the difference between, you know, just like showing up to an event and leaving is that I have to talk to a lot of people. It's a lot of close contact. And people, I mean, I like to talk. So, I mean, I'll talk with people after the event and just kind of talk. So, I mean, that exposure to a lot of people is not good. Cause, you know, I got to remember that I have a family that also is at risk or whatever. So I got to make sure I don't increase the risk for no reason. That's why I'm like, do I even want to invest in this studio right now? Because I have a home studio, but I was thinking about, I was before the Corona stuff, thinking about investing in leasing a studio space, a commercial studio space, and having a bunch of people come in and do a bunch of stuff. But the problem with that is that it's just Corona happened, so it's a lot different now. So I'm kind of thinking. I'm trying to read all this. You wrote a lot. Thanks for responding and your time a lot. So that's what I thought. I'm recording using an Apollo Twin. Okay, you have the same setup as me, basically. In FL, route my vocal to a separate mixer channel with effects. But only auto-tune shows that red delay thingy. Yeah, it's just the regular auto-tune. Don't have the UA one. I think the regular one has live mode. So if you do have the regular one, just put it on live mode if you have that version of it. That should fix it. But if not, then it might just be a Mac thing on FL because that's been happening to me. So it's not just a you thing. It's a me thing too. Kodo Beats. Yo. Once again, thanks for... Oh yeah, shout out to you. Yeah, I mean, it's just not worth, like, I mean, the live events were just something for you guys. It wasn't really like a money-making thing. It wasn't for anything super big. It was just, now I did have bigger plans for it, but that can wait. It wasn't like a huge profit center or anything for the business. So it can be put on the back burner for now. AJML, shout out for the shout out. I mean, thank you for the shout out. Okay, so let's try and get these drums right. Now, also keep in mind, there's another plugin called Ample Guitar. They gave me SC. I don't even know what this is. Okay, let me click. Oh, I thought they would give that to me for free. I think he sent that to me by accident. I don't know if they got rid of Ample Guitar F. What? I don't feel like doing all this. I just entered my data yesterday. I don't feel like reactivating it. But what you would do is plug in your stuff, and that's the electric guitar version of it. I just don't feel like re-entering my whole thing. SK Mark. Live at the BBQ. What time is it? Yeah, we'll go to the song feedback in a little bit. Melody a little bit better. Let's consolidate that. Now, nothing's going to be a live guitar. I did have a plan to work with artists. Oh, you mean like big artists? But no, I'm talking about develop my own artists just for fun, just to see where we could take it. But no, I work with big companies. I don't chase the artists because the companies own the artists. So I'm like, why am I chasing somebody that's owned by somebody else? So I go for the big companies. That's what I do. My philosophy is people are chasing a Drake placement. And I say, what is Drake chasing? He's not chasing a Drake placement. He's chasing an Adidas placement. So I'm looking at the bigger brand deals. That's how I think, though. Not everybody thinks that way. But this should be going through track. Stimulus package. Yeah, I didn't even promote that really. I forgot. There's just so much going on that I'm like, oh, I forgot to say this. I forgot to tell people about this. Mr. Malone says, do you have any Serum preset? Wait, do you do any Serum preset building? I don't do custom work. I don't do work for hire stuff. But I mean, I can show you how to use Serum. I don't have Serum on this computer either. Do you work with artists or just make beat? Oh, I answered that already. What brands? If you go to my website, BusyWorks Beats, we did a deal with a $1 billion company called Razer, which is a gaming laptop. So we did that with them. So Razer's the first one. They're the $1 billion company. So again, that one company is worth more than all the artists that people work with combined. So that's why I don't chase artists as much. Universal Audio, very great company. I'm using a lot of their stuff right now. ImageLine, that made FL Studio. TuneCore, Isotope, Akai, Arturia. Sweetwater is a $600 million company. Waves, I'm not sure what they're worth. Serato, on and on and on and on and on. All the top companies in the audio space, which is fun because it's more fun to work with them most of the time. Some people don't get it. Like Waves doesn't get it, but most other companies get it. Oh, like tutorials for Serum? I'm gonna have to re-download it because on this computer I was just trying to use as much stock stuff as possible just to get an idea of how people feel when they're starting all over again. But I'll look into downloading Serum again. I don't know if I have to buy it again because I have it for PC. I don't know if you have to rebuy it or whatever, but Will Crumb Brands Who Hit Well? I don't know how to read that. Will Crumb Brands Who Hit Well? Not sure what that means. Alright, let's add a kick in here. I know for sure in the Ultimate Kit 1 there's a kick called... Notice when you stack the kick at the 808, they have a different texture now. It doesn't feel as hard, so let's push it. Running through a soft clipper. Pretty soft clipper. Fruity. Soft clipper. Turn the threshold up. We start leveling because the beat doesn't need to be this high. Also, let me run the 808 through a distortion plugin. How do you feel about Splice? I don't like the model of Splice. I think they're devaluing all the content creators that contribute to Splice. Never heard your thoughts on it or even use it. I used it only to get the sounds from the people that I like Scott Storch. Murda Beats had something on there. Sunny Digital, I supported him. Wonder Girl. I don't know if Boy Wonder had a kit on there. Lex Luger, I think I got his thing. I don't know if I got the Zaytoven kit. All the people that we know, I supported them. The Cap Sun, the Decap kits. But all the other stuff on Splice, I just didn't even bother with it. Because what they do is they give you a dope sound and then they put you right next to a whack sound. And they say, they're both worth one credit. So they're basically making your sounds a commodity in order to consolidate the sound market. Which I think is just extracting all your talents and just they're just leveraging the fact that people don't know how to make money off their sounds. And people are just contributing to their conglomerate every day, signing their sounds away because you guys don't understand how much potential you have in your sound kits, so you just give it away. Do you have the second kick off beat after the third? Yeah, it's like a little offbeat 808. How do you feel about crack plugins? I don't judge because I remember the beginning of the production journey where people would like look up like contact libraries that they would just try to, here's the reason why people talk about contact libraries so much. It's because they thought they were easy to pirate without getting into all the key generations and all that. So what people used to do was like, if you wanted a plugin back in the day, you would download the plugin and then it would ask you for a serial code. And people are like, crap, I don't have a serial code. So the people who cracked the plugin, which I don't know why people crack plugins. It's like, make your own plugin. Like, why are you cracking plugins? Like, if you have this much talent, go make your own plugin. But anyway, for the people who did crack the plugins, they would make these things called key generators. And basically it would just generate like a number and it would give the plugin a password and it would open up. And the issue became that people wanted certain plugins, but then when it said enter your serial code, the key generators wouldn't work. So people got really frustrated about cracking plugins because they're always like, okay, I have the plugin, but then the key gen doesn't work. So like it would just be downloading stuff for no reason. So that would be what they would go through. And the reason they like contact libraries is because you don't need a key gen to download the samples for the contact libraries. So that's why people were aiming for contact libraries. And that's why you saw people with the most random contact library. Like contact libraries from these third-party companies are really expensive. Like I just bought contact libraries that are worth like $500 a piece and they were on sale, so I bought them, but it took me 5 years to buy some of those libraries by third party people. So I can see it's not for everybody to just immediately jump into those high-end things in music production. There's still some things in music production I'm like, who would spend $60,000 on an SSL console? There's still like a higher level to buying equipment. There's speakers worth $10,000 a piece. It's just like a nonstop. Like I'm always looking at music. Like this stuff does not get cheap at all. But we have to remember like why it's expensive. And that's because people dedicate their entire careers to build like one speaker and they're banking on that for the rest of their life. So, I mean, the fact that people went to school just to build a speaker, we got to respect that at least. Cause I mean, I don't know how to build a speaker. So that's my opinion. I don't judge people who download stuff. I get it. It's just the people that upload the stuff. I just don't understand that lifestyle. Like, I just don't get it. Do you sign producers? Maybe soon. I have something in the works. It's almost like you're reading my mind because I'm writing a book that kind of goes over a little bit of that. But I sign producers in a new way, put it that way. It's not your typical like publishing deal bullcrap way. I'm talking about a new way that we do business, and I'm definitely looking to build a team. I just got to wait for all the paperwork to clear and all this. I used to produce for Cue that rude boy. Cue the rude boy. Shout out to the wave man, 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 man. For a short time, but I was wondering if you take producers for your team and mentor them. Do you make videos too, OG 90s? Because that would definitely help you in this scenario if you made videos too. What's your college experience? I didn't go to school for music. I went to school for biology, pre-med specifically. I went to Villanova University, which is outside of Philadelphia. And I went for biology and that I studied pre-med. Basically, I started a pre-med club with my roommate sophomore year, which taught me entrepreneurship. And that's why I kind of went on my own other way, because I learned what being a boss, not a boss, that sounds so stupid. I learned how starting and running a business actually is, and it became fun. And I just wanted to do that for the rest of my life. I wonder if those speakers make you hear colors. Yeah, these freaking, I've been in a, this is a random story mode, but I went to the Isotope headquarters up in Cambridge, Massachusetts, and they have these tall speakers, and it's a whole mastering studio. It's for mastering songs. And let me tell you, when you play your song on those speakers, you hear every detail that's wrong. And it like makes your, it makes your feel, it makes your song feel so small. Like, you think your song's booming and big. You go to their speakers, it feels like a little tiny box. And you're like, what was I mixing on? And that's why I said, don't get caught up too much about watching these master classes and these like Pensado things. Because Pensado's probably in a room that costs hundreds of thousands, if not $100,000. So his perception on the song is way different than yours. So I'm not saying this to knock Pensado. I'm just saying that you don't want to beat up on yourself. Or whoever, I'm just saying Pensado because he's the main guy. You don't want to beat up on yourself as to why you're not getting your mix to sound a certain way. It's because you're learning from people who are in a whole different environment than you. And they can see it from a different perspective. So you just have to learn how to mix in your room, and hopefully I can help you with that. So we got about 8 minutes till we go live. I mean, till we do the song feedback. I mean, trap beats really haven't changed much. It's really just about the song idea. Oh yeah. I never even thought that study. Like how colors and visuals. Here's a cool little side fact. In law, or you know, in traditional music business, what they did was they considered a song not only the audio, they considered a song the audio and the visual. So if you came out with a music video, they own that as well as the audio. And that means a lot, because if you define a song as audio and visual, then that means visual dictates how we perceive it. This is not gonna work if my dog's gonna be barking over your songs. My goodness. But anyway, hold on, y'all. Let's make them big. So we got Stefan Wall in the house. I don't know how to make this bigger without turning performance mode on. It might drop frames, so give me a second.
Is that OBS?
Who? OBS? This is called Streamlabs. Oh, okay. Let me make it bigger. Hold up.
OBS is... Open broadcaster software.
Say it again.
Open broadcaster software, I think.
Yeah, we can't see ourselves because it saves CPU or whatever, but gotcha. You're on cam. Y'all want to see it? We got Asher. We got Stefan Waller. Is that red or black? Oh, I can't tell because the green light. You want to say what's up? Oh, now you don't want to bark? But this is Sinead Monique's little boy here, Asher Waller. This is Stefan Waller. Oh, right here. We can see ourselves. Duh.
Three-month baby.
Oh, yeah. He's 3 months now. This is Sinead's, what do you call it, fraternal twin? Yeah. Paternal? No.
We're not identical, so yes, fraternal.
Fraternal.
Yeah. Had me thinking for a second.
Fraternal twin.
Nobody says that, right? Are you guys fraternal?
Born the same day.
You appled up right now.
Darn, this thing is... I think ever since I switched it off, the performance is glitching. Darn it. But whatever.
You team apple.
You could do the sidecar. You could treat this like a monitor now. Mm-hmm. So you can hit a button and this will switch into a second monitor.
Oh, that's cool.
No need for all that extra.
Oh, but he don't want to get the two monitors set up. But he kind of did it low key, right?
Mm-hmm. That was part of my buying decision. I saw somebody do it. I
Oh, did you? Okay.
I was like, freak, I could use my iPad that I never use.
Yeah, I've never seen someone do that before.
You look like an actual baby.
He is a baby, right? My baby.
My baby. She's slowly falling in love with her child.
I loved him the day I got him.
They are like, not Bonnie and Clyde. Who's a non-criminal Bonnie and Clyde?
I don't know. I think Asher would rob a bank with me, right?
He's mischievous, but they get the dynamic is pretty dope.
Right, I'll let you get back there.
Oh, I didn't know what y'all were up to. I was just trying to make King be quiet because King was just barking and barking and barking.
So he said he smelled me or something.
He's like threat. Oh, dang. But she's still training Asher, so he's a young one. What doll is your fave and which one is your least fave? I would say my fave is FL just because I know my way around. Logic is my second favorite, like the way it works and the sounds. Ableton's cool though for audio. But the least favorite is probably like Reaper. I never open up Reaper. Not that I hate Reaper, it's just I don't use it. Or, hold on, my dog is barking. Hold on. Sheesh, can't have him barking during the live. But, yeah, two dogs in the house is not what I thought it would be. This is a whole different experience. You got to make sure they get along. Lil Frey, LIDB. So let's kick up the live stream. I'm going to run and take a little break. I don't know if I could play something while you guys are waiting. What could I play? I don't have waiting music. Standby music. What I may do is go live again because it looks like the live stream is glitching a little bit. So what I may do is reset the live. I'll do that. That way all the stream music can be in one thing. So I'll be right back, and we'll do a quick little Q&A before we start. All right, so I'll see you guys in 2 to 5 minutes.